Thanks to the counts. I'm 50 years old, and I'm a two-time survivor.
Yeah.
Divorce. So I'd ask some of my younger millennial friends for some advice on dating in the 21st century, and they told me to use this dating app, Tinder. It is the shallowest way to meet members of the opposite sex ever. Picture pops up, you either like it or you don't. If you like it, you swipe right. If you don't like it, you swipe left. Two of you swipe right, you're a match, and you start communicating after you click through some Viagra ads. Either one of you swipe left, no match, nothing happens, except some Viagra ads. But anyway, men and women handle this completely different. Women, you inspect every single picture that pops up over and over and over again. You and two of your friends huddle around your smartphone like three nuns looking for a typo in the Bible, and it begins.
He looks so much better in this picture than he does in the other ones. It's probably old. Whose shoulder is that next to him? That's blonde hair. He's probably not even single. He's wearing a hat in every picture. He's probably bald.
The fellow's method is a little different. I do her. I do her. No. Then you get the coveted match.
Oh, look, me and Studley Homewell are a match. What do I do if I text him first and I look desperate?
You're on Tinder, you're desperate.
But what if he's waiting for you to text him first?
He's not waiting.
But he is waiting for you to text him first, and you don't, you might never hear from him. He's not waiting.
We fellas handle the matches a little bit different as well. Matches. Cool. Hi. How was your day? Sit. Copy. Paste. Sit.
Message from Studley Homewell. He says, hi, how was your day? Hi, Studley. OMG, I hit the snooze button too many times this morning. I had to get up so fast and jump in the shower that I had to take Wally for a walk so fast. I don't think he got it all out. LOL, no time for coffee, so I had to go through McDonald's, which means I had to have a cinnamon bun. Yum! Guess I'll have to take some more sweaty yoga class this week. LOL, how was your day, Sam?
Good. I wish you were my little toe so I could bang you on every piece of furniture in my house. Say. Tinder. That's actually a true story, and she's here tonight. Hey, babe, I love you. I'm sorry. She is absolutely awesome. She's super fit. She works out every day. She would love it if I was super fit and I worked out every day. So we bought each other these fitness bands here. And it says that for me to be in great shape, I need to take 10,000 steps a day. It also says that to get the most out of it, I need a workout buddy. So now we're a virtual fitness team. It's awesome. That means we can see how many steps each other are taking every single day. That also means she can see when I'm sitting, when I'm standing, when I'm walking, when I'm running, when I'm sleeping, and when I wake up. I thought this was a fitness tool, not an ankle bracelet. I walked into this thing on day one. She had 6,200 steps by noon. I had four. So then I remember her daughter tells me that hers counted folding clothes as taking steps. Or something like that. Obviously, folding clothes ain't gonna happen in my house every day. So I thought about taping it to the ceiling fan, right? But that constant spinning, that was gonna flatline my chart, and I was gonna get busted. So I put it on the dog's collar. That idiot lays around more than I do. So I got a paddle ball, you know, one of those ping pong paddle looking things with the rubber band and the ball on the end, bit, one of those things, you know? Problem solved. I'm watching TV, playing with my paddle ball, bit. Sitting at my desk, playing with my paddle ball, bit. Hotgirls.com, bit. No paddle ball required. She is so proud. She tells me, you are absolutely crushing it. You're jogging 2 and 3 times a day. That's awesome. But what's with all the 2 a.m. wind sprints every night? That's my time. Thank you very much.